Why are nights like tonight that celebrate Indian cinema so special and important, do you think?
Yeah, it's so important, especially given the historical ties between the two countries. I'm a result of that. I'm a third generation immigrant, so I'm so happy we have a festival like this. It's so random how it happened, but I moved to London when I was 18 and I got an ad while I was here. It aired in India, and next thing I knew, Mumbai kept calling me and I went over to do more ads and I walked away with a film. So I was really, really lucky.
Can you talk a little bit about, obviously, the stereotypes people have about Bollywood, how much of that is accurate, how much of that is just myth and magic?
I think Bollywood has now become less of an industry and people associate it as a genre. So when I tell my friends that I've done a film in India, I kind of say it's just a Hindi language film because the one I did is so not Bollywood. There was no singing or dancing. I shaved my hair off. It was not glamorous whatsoever. But I think Hindi cinema, you know, it's starting to make a name for itself worldwide, especially with streaming and the globalization that's happening with Netflix and Amazon Prime. So I'm really happy about that because language is no longer a barrier. I think there are so many unjust stereotypes of India and of Indian immigrants, especially the way the Western media perpetrates them. You know, when you look at Apu from The Simpsons, most people think that's what everyone from India is like, and that's not true. So if, you know, we can create our own content, and tell our own stories and present that to the world, then those stereotypes will be diminished and there'll be a fairer representation all round.
Are there stories that you're working on at the moment? Do you have other projects at the moment?
Yeah, I've just signed a film with, I'm doing a film with Craig Roberts, he's directing, and Sally Hawkins is in it. I've got, all I can say is my role is small, but I'm just super excited to be working with her, so that's coming up soon. We're shooting next week, I think.
Is there anything that you've already done that is releasing soon? Anything we should be looking for?
In terms of films, no. I'm kind of just, I just finished my university degree, so I had to focus on that. So now I'm kind of getting my foot back in the park and I'm trying to get the ball rolling now.
I mean, obviously we've got some great talents here tonight. Are there particular Indian icons, particularly actresses that you look up to that you'd aspire to be more like?
I love Aamir Khan and I love Irfan Khan. If I could even just meet them and have a meeting with them one day, I'd be so happy. I think they're absolutely brilliant. They're just absolute artists and they have so much pride in what they do and I think they're so talented.
Is there one film in particular that you would hold out as an example of just how special and wonderful Indian cinema can be?
Not to be biased, but all of Shujit Sakhar's films, my director, I love his films. Also, I think Aamir Khan's Dangal was incredible. Uttar Punjab. There are so many examples that aren't really mainstream or globally known, which I think deserve to be. So I could go on.
Talk that. I mean, obviously, you're biased because he's your director now. But can you talk? Do you know about what that experience was like and what makes him such a very special presence behind the camera?
He's just an actor's director, and I honestly believe that he's done, you know, 80% of the work for me. And we just had such a special bond. And he's so chilled and relaxed. He never made me feel inferior because of my lack of experience. And it was just an amazing shoot.